Hello, this is John, host of Mgtow is Freedom. I want to thank everyone for subscribing. This channel has grown tremendously, quickly, and there's a lot of great opinions out there. And I like sharing mine with yours and seeing what you guys have to say. One of the things I like to say is we're all men going our own way. We all have our own ideas. We like to talk about them. You know, one of the things I don't like, though, is labels. If you want to criticize the concepts, criticize them. But, you know, just calling someone derogatory names right off the bat, to me, that sounds a little bit like control. So I always tell everybody, when you talk to me, watch how you talk to me, and I'll try and have the same courtesy and respect for them. Labels, labels, labels. One of the tricks the feminists use, and they've tricked men into using name calling because we're not allowed to throw down dukes anymore. But this channel is about the arena of ideas, and that's what we're going to talk about today, are some ideas. You know, a lot of the MGTOW video producers like to talk about how they're going to look out for themselves. You know, and it's a good plan, it's a good idea to work out how to take care of yourself. You know, if you can't handle yourself, how can you deal with the bigger picture? What I've got on this tremendous board here is the bigger picture. And it's going to be kind of hard to see because I started thinking about the problem we face as men. And it can't be summed up in one video, and it can't be summed up in one large picture. So I'm going to start at the top and we're going to go all the way to the bottom. And this is the history of the world right up till where we're at now as men see it. So let's start way at the top with the world. Right up here, that's the world. Okay? We've got to deal with survival as men. So we got shelter, food, protection. I got dollar signs up there, but that means resources. The things that we find valuable. Things that we need to survive, to live comfortably. And as men, we conquer the world. Man conquers the world, and everyone knows that. Men are still trying to conquer the world. They've never given up on that. They conquer as much as they can. And when you win, man gets food, shelter, resources, money, clothing, and sex. That's what we get. That's what we have the opportunity to get when we conquer, when we win, when we do what men do. Okay? So that's happened for thousands of years, in tens of thousands of years. Men conquer. They conquered the animals and kicked them out of the caves, and those early men took the caves. Caveman. Man conquered his neighbors in war, and those became his conquests, and he built towns, he built cities, he built civilization on the philosophy of the need to conquer and then the need to cooperate. And that brings us to a very, very important part of this. Man wants to keep what he has earned. What he has conquered, man wants to keep. There's so much conquering a man does, and then a man also wants peace in his life. This is a common complaint. Common complaint that MGTOW have is they want peace. They may not use that exact word, but they don't want all the bitching and griping and having to explain themselves all the time to loud, obnoxious, feminist women. So man wants peace. Man wants to keep what he has earned. So in order to do that, he has created various types of government. Governments that have laws and rules to help people get along and understand each other. Kind of a unified philosophy of living. So in order to keep what he has conquered and to live comfortably and peacefully as he can, man created government. And after man conquers and creates this government, and we get all the way up to the United States, the best form of government, the U.S. Constitution ever created. It didn't say that the king was free. It said everyone was free. It didn't say that the king gets gets to keep what is his, but every man gets to keep what is his, what he has earned, what he has conquered. So man created government, and then women, after that, demanded equality, a fair share. I've taken us right up in world history to the equal rights movement, which started way back in the 1800s. Okay? Way back then, women have been getting the right to vote, the right to own property, the right to this, the right to that, and they demand the right to everything. It's a man's world, and women want it. Woman declares war, the battle of the sexes. You're all familiar with the battle of the sexes. There was a tennis match between Billie Jean King and Bobby Riggs in the 70s. But that was just a game that was played for show, and of course the woman won, you know. Early form of propaganda. But the battle of the sexes have been going on from the very beginning of time. Back when man was conquering, he used his brains and his brawn to conquer, and women were part of the prize, way up there. And man has kept his prize until now, until the battle of the sexes started, when they got equal rights. Did the women want to live in peace? No. Did the women want to go out and conquer on their own? No. They wanted to be given everything. Given everything. Entitlement. Why? Because women have always been given everything. There's nothing new there. But now they want to do it without having to perform, having to work for it. And so on this battle of the sexes, there is a battlefield. And this is where men have not realized the gravity of the shit they face. And Mgtow and Mgtow video makers have done a great job of bringing out all the various areas in which women get away with stealing men's resources, their time, their private selves. So on the battlefield, we have feminazi strategy. Feminazi strategy. Just like Hitler, who attacked on two fronts. He attacked the English and the Americans in the West, and he went after Russia in the East, and he actually was fighting in Africa in the South. Three fronts. The feminazis that we're dealing with also have a multi-pronged blitzkrieg attack on men. They weren't happy with settling with just one attack. They went after us on every front. Okay, pincher attack. You know, outflanking us. You know, rolling up through the middle. So let's take a look at the ways in which they've done it. They've used government. Government, which man created way up here, forms of government, so that he could keep what he has earned. He created government, man did. And woman, one of the first things they did when they got the right to vote, they started using government to get what they want from us. They created laws special for women to prefer women and give women special rights and privileges. And all it has done is fostered their entitlement mentality. Courts. Courts interpret the laws. They even make up their own rules. They ignore rules. If you're a man and you go to court, you think you've got equal rights? Forget it. It's over. So government was number one. Women got the right to vote. They got the right to have property. And then they started taking our stuff, using laws and courts. Stealing men's efforts. That is what occurred there. Then we look over at entertainment. Another front on the battlefield. Another front in which the feminazis use their strategy. Propaganda. That is done through movies, television, radio, books, everything they can that gets into people's minds. Their entertainment has propaganda in it. Inside that same entertainment, social pressure is developed for men to conform and give in to women's wants. You can't escape it. It is all around us. This entertainment creates false expectations by women, and they put them on men. So through entertainment, we have propaganda, social pressure, false expectations, and also emulation. Women emulate the tough girl, the smart girl, the clever girl. Everything they see in media, music, they re-sing the songs. Movies, they act like they are men because men conquer and women are now conquering. The battlefield has to do with entertainment. So they emulate their entertainment stars. And they do not back up. Women are never wrong now that they're empowered. And men give in. So men get their efforts stolen by government. And men give in to the pressures created in the entertainment industry. If you look over at professional industry, the workplace, yet another front on which the feminazi strategy is brought to the battlefield. Women have invaded the man's workplace. Invaded it. They think that they should be in our workplace wherever they see fit. And, you know, hey, equal rights, we're all free. But they don't compete freely. They are selfish. Women have selfishness in the professional workplace. They bring their stuff, their drama, their attitude, and make everyone else have to deal with it. Because they're selfish, just like they are everywhere else. These feminist women are very selfish. And they push for what they want. They demand equality, meaning equal pay for unequal work. That's right. They say they want equal pay for equal work, but women have lower production on average. Much lower production. And I've challenged people before. Look at what women are doing at their desks. I get sick every day at work looking at women surfing, Facebook, Candy Crusher, everything internet at work. They are not very productive. And so as a result of women getting into the workplace and flooding the workplace with excessive workers, their selfish attitude, their demand for equality and lower production means that men who want to work are now underpaid because of the glut of workers in the professional industry. So it used to be that it was just men that worked, for the most part. And I'm sure I'm going to hear about this. Women have always worked, blah, blah, blah. I don't care. This isn't about women and what they think I should be talking about. Women in the workplace. We're not talking about just secretaries. We're talking about the man's world. And so women started working. And it raised the cost of everything, the expense of everything. So now we went from one income to keep a household going to two incomes. And now everyone has to work because men are underpaid due to the lower production. The demand for equality by women, the same pay, even though they're not doing the same work. Selfishness, bringing their personal lives into work. Just the general invasion. And another front, we're fighting the feminazis, the feminists on the battlefield. Social. Men are required by social standards to give in to women. They're softer, they cry, they whine, they guilt, they shame. Guilt and shame. Men give in because of social pressure. Right? I shouldn't be talking about this. It's rude of me to point all this out. It's rude of me to have an opinion. I shouldn't even be breathing. I'm white. I'm a male. I have patriarchy on my side.